Morning students, welcome back to the online class. Today we are going to discuss the next revision class, this revision part 2. Revision 2. In this revision 2 part, we will discuss the second part chapter, third chapter and fourth chapter and also fifth chapter. The main thing is the what is actually computer and what are the strengths or characteristics of computer. So computers are what? Computer means what? It is an electronic device which is used to give the input from the user and you will get the output. Okay? So now see, these are the strengths or you can say characteristics or you can say advantage of computer speed. So definitely computers are so speed, you can do any problem or any operations in a very quick time. Accuracy gives accurate results. High capacity storage, you can store lot of information in the computers. Okay. Now the resilience means what? You perform the last calculations with the same accuracy and speed as the first ones. Okay. Whatever speed he performed at the first time, the speed is same speed and same accuracy you will give at the last time. This means resilience. Versatility. We can watch video, we can watch movies, we can play game, we can create any documents, so things etc. We can do with the help of computer. So this is called versatility. Okay. So these are the advantages of versatility. These are the advantages of computers. Okay. Application, it is used in business. Okay, business. In every business nowadays computers are so important. Means in every business. It may be like a wholesale, retailers, a small businessman also use the computers. Okay? And a big company also use computers. Okay? Now number two is entertainment. Entertainment. Okay. Computers can be used to listen music, watch movie, play game and also create this. Okay. So means what? We can play game, we can watch movie. We can play game. We can create some entertainment with the help of computers. Okay, number three is education. Means that in education the computers are used. See, like this, all the classrooms today is actually a smart class. In our Pramzirika, there is a smart class classroom. So in a smart class you can view your chapters, your lessons with the help of computers. Okay, so this means what? Everything computers can be used by teachers to prepare lessons, reports cards. Computer also allow us to access internet, which is vast information resources. Okay, with the help of internet we can do this type of things. Means what? We can prepare our lessons, we can create select PPT, select PowerPoint presentations, we can also connect the internet also. Okay, so these are many things you can done with the help of computers. Okay, next thing is communication. Number four is communication. Communications means what? Computers allow us to communicate through emails, chat, video and conferencing. Okay, means what? Communication means what? We can send any information through emails, video conferencing, chatting, etc. We can do with the help of computers. So in communications, computers are very much used. Okay. Now see, next is airplane or airlines radio reservation. Okay. Number five is airlines or railway reservation. Okay. We can book our tickets. Now see, computers are also used for airlines reservations, railway reservations. Means that the computer and reservation counters are connected through the common networks. Okay, means well, we can reserve or we can book our airline tickets, railway tickets through computers. Nowadays there are many apps, say like Mintra, GoIBGo, ClearTrips. So many apps in nowadays. Just I'm just install these apps and we can access anything. Means we can book any tickets. Means if I want to go from Guwahati to Delhi, you can easily book any tickets in any day. Okay, this is called airlines and reservations, railway reservations. So these are the application of computers. Okay. Logistic. Number 5, you can say graphics tablet scanner. Okay, number 5 please. Scanner. So these are one, the input devices. Input device means what? We can give some input to the computers through this type of devices. So like keyboard, mouse, iPad, joysticks, scanner. Okay? If you have any problem in this input device, just you can call me. So these are our output devices. Output device means what? With the help of these devices, we can get the output from the computer or from the CPU. You can view the outputs. Say monitor, printer and speakers. Okay, these are the output devices. Okay, problem in these devices, say like output and input devices, please call me. Okay. Access. Okay, memory. Okay, it is also called RAM. And read only memory. It is called read only memory. Read only memory. Okay. RAM is a volatile memory. RAM is a what? It is a volatile memory. And it is a non-volatile. Okay. Now see, volatile in RAM, whatever the information is stored in the RAM, if the power is gone, then whatever the information is stored in the RAM, it will automatically erase or it will automatically clear from the RAM. So this is for what? Volatile memory. Non-volatile memory means what? This is means what? It is permanent, fixed. It cannot be erased. For example, when you boot your computer at time, whatever the memory we require, it is coming from the RAM, sorry, ROM. Okay, so that's why ROM is called non-volatile memory. Okay, so these are the what? RAM and ROM. Okay, so operating systems. Operating system are nothing. It is means it is a software which is used to operate the our computers. Means they control our computer. Okay, this is called operating system. Now see what are the functions of operating system. Okay, so these are the functions. Okay, these are the functions of operating system. Process manager means what? We can control the process of the our operating systems. Okay. Means what? It keeps records. It keeps track of processors sharing by the considering whether the processor is busy or what. Memory, whatever the memory of computers, it will be controlled by the memory management. File management all means the file is one purpose. It is read, write or execute. Okay? It manages the input and output devices, say like printers. It is called input devices like keyboards, mouse, these are all controlled by the device management. So these are the functions of operating systems. Okay, these are the examples of operating systems. Base. Interactive means what? Zero base means all the information or all the content will be coming in graphically. Okay, in device what happens? Only blue screen is coming and only just you can enter the numbers or enter the finding. Okay, but in GUI what happens? All the informations are coming in GUI means graphically. That means what? It is interact with the people in a specific time period. For example, robots. Robots it means what? It is based on the real time operating systems. Okay. So in distributed operating system what happens? There are many computers. Okay, but only one computer can control this. Other computers. This is called distributed computer by through a network. Okay. This one also a component of MS Word. These are very important. In your exams, many come one of the components of MS Word. Okay, you write this all things. Okay, steps are in this chapter. How to write the steps to create a document, write the steps to format a document. So all things you have to be very carefully read, and you have to remember all the steps, because you don't know which steps will come into your exams. Okay, so that's why be careful. Say spelling and grammar. Okay, how to check the spelling and grammar into your documents. So these are steps given here in the books. Okay, you just remember the steps. Okay, you can find any words, and also you can replace any words. Okay, so this is called find and replace. Even this one, rows and columns. Okay, these are called what? These are called rows, and these are called columns. These are called rows. Okay, so even this one, it's a combination of rows and columns. Okay, so these are called tables. So how to create tables? We can do series. Okay, so in this way, you can create tables in a Word document. Okay, so these are the steps given here. So main point is what? In mail marts, what happens, you can mail a document in different people or different persons. Just you have to write one document, and after that you can send this mail or send this letter to different people at the same time. Okay, this is called mail marts. You can see mail marts, the steps are given here. How to start a mail marts, how to create a data source. So these are very important things. So that's why you have to be very serious in this chapter. This chapter is actually it's contain all these steps given here. So I think you understand this revision class. It's a huge chapters, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it will take times, but I'm just giving the hints for other types of questions come in your exams. Okay, so in the second revision you will get the next database and it is the database and query. Okay, we will get these things in the next revision class. Okay, so if you have any problem after watching this video, just comment me and ask me. So you can directly contact me. My WhatsApp number, you know my WhatsApp number. My WhatsApp number, directly you your query you can give and say I will resolve it as soon as possible. Okay, friends, thank you for watching this video. Again, I say stay home and be safe. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Have a great day.